mechanism of Indian monsoons. So as we learned earlier, in climate,
winds are generally moving from the high pressure areas towards the
high atmospheric pressure towards as a low atmospheric pressure.
Winds are generally moving from the high atmospheric pressure towards the low atmospheric pressure. Towards the low atmospheric pressure. So on this principle, the Gilbert, G-I-L-L-B-E-R-T, Gilbert, it initiated as a traditional concept of a traditional theory of Indian monsoons. Monsoons which are caused the rainfall in a month of June, July, August. It is a result of such atmospheric conditions which are generally prevailing as a high pressure over a Indian Ocean and at the same time the low pressure developing over a Great Plains of India. While the reason is a summer solstice. The state of a summer solstice, 21st of June, when sun rays are made fall vertical over a tropic of Cancer. Under such circumstances, high temperature receiving over the plains of India due to the intense heat, the high heat prevailing over a Great Plains of India, winds which are heated up due to as a high temperature, they becomes as a lighter and light winds as rises in an upward direction. Due to as a movement of a vertical movement of a winds in an upward direction, which leads to the development of a low pressure areas. So that's why in a months of a June, July, August, winds are moving from the south towards the northward. Afterwards, September, October, November, the wind starts to move from a north towards the southward. Winds generally which are moving from the south towards the northward are the sea breezes. Sea breezes, because the high pressure is developing over Indian Ocean. Clear? High pressure development over Indian Ocean. In the same time, the low pressure developing over the plains of India. That's why winds are moving from south towards northward. So let's start to discuss what as basically the monsoons which are emerging in a tropical conditions of India. Tropical, yes, Kerala to Jammu and Kashmir. Monsoons are generally as moving from a southward Kerala. First they approaching towards a Kerala, then moving towards as the other parts of India, and at the last they are approaching towards the Punjab and J&K. Clear? So before the study of a monsoon, we have to know about it. There are whole of the world as Earth has divided into the seven atmospheric pressure belts. Seven pressure belts are there. First, 0 degree. This is the largest latitude of the Earth. It is an equatorial low pressure belt. Equator is the latitude. This is as an atmospheric pressure belt also. Equatorial low pressure belt. Second is a 30 degree. This is not as a 23.5 degree. This is a belt, not as a tropical area. 30 degree north and 30 degree south. 30 degree south. This is known as a subtropical high pressure belt. Subtropical high pressure belt. Same as in the southern hemisphere. Subtropical high pressure belt. Clear? Subtropical high pressure belt, 30 degree north and south. 30 degree north and south. Next belt is a 60 degree north, 60 degree south. 60 degree south. That is known as a subpolar low pressure belt. 60 degree north, 60 degree south is known as a subpolar low pressure belt. Subpolar low pressure belt. Afterwards, at the end, North Pole and South Pole. South Pole, this is as existence of a polar high pressure belt. Why David B has a high pressure? Because due to the cold weather conditions, low temperature conditions throughout the year, winds are lies nearer the surface. That's why the in polar regions, high pressure has developing. High pressure developing in a polar regions due to the low temperature conditions. Low temperature conditions. Yes, this is as a mechanism, Harry. This is a mechanism of Indian monsoons. In India, mein monsoons kis tarah aate hain? Which has explained in your book as a mechanism of Indian monsoons. Same we are discussing here. In your book, as a 4 points are given, all these points I will explain here one by one, which has marked on a next page of a map. On your book, fifth page, after the map, after two maps, consecutive two maps of Central Asia are there. Next page ke upar, 4 points given honge. So it has related with the such 4 points. So polar high pressure belt. So world divided into the 7 atmospheric pressure belt, polar high pressure belt, subpolar low pressure belt in northern hemisphere, subtropical high pressure belt in northern hemisphere, equatorial low pressure belt. Fifth one, subtropical high pressure belt in a southern hemisphere. Sixth one, subpolar low pressure belt in a southern hemisphere. And seventh one, polar high pressure belt. Clear? 7 atmospheric belts are there. They are associated with a 30 degree north and 30 degree south. 30 degree north and 30 degree south. 30 degree south. 30 degree south. 0 degree. 30 degree north. Monsoons winds are developing in this zone. 30 degree north to 30 degree south means subtropical high pressure belt in northern and the southern hemisphere. Northern and southern hemisphere. Clear? Northern and southern hemisphere. If the earth not rotate around its axis, what will be happen over earth? Under such circumstances, winds will move as a vertical. If the earth not rotate around its axis, under such circumstances, the movement of a winds looks like this. Why? Because winds are moving from high pressure to the low pressure. Subtropical high pressure belt towards the equatorial low pressure belt. Subtropical high pressure belt towards the equatorial low pressure belt. Clear? If earth not rotate around its axis, but earth is rotating around its axis. Earth rotates around its axis. That's why due to rotation of our earth, there is a force exerted on the surface of the earth, which is known as a Coriolis force. Coriolis force. It is known as a Coriolis force. Coriolis. Coriolis force. So the role of this force is, it diverts winds. Due to rotation of earth, winds are diverted as a left-hand side in southern hemisphere, left-hand side in southern hemisphere, and right-hand side in a northern hemisphere. Right-hand side in northern hemisphere. How? Because if the Gurupal has standing on a tropic of Capricorn or a 30 degree southern hemisphere, if the Gurupal standing on a southern hemisphere, his face is towards the equator. So winds diverted as a left-hand side. If Gurupal standing in a northern hemisphere, looking towards the South Pole or the equator, then winds are diverted in a right-hand side. From northern hemisphere as a right-hand side, in southern hemisphere as a left-hand side. This diversion of winds is known as a Ferenc law. Diversion of winds in both the hemispheres is known as a Farrell's law. FERRELS, Farrell's law. I'm again repeating, as a Farrell's law is the phenomena. Farrell's law is a phenomena in which winds are diverted left-hand side in southern hemisphere, left-hand side in southern hemisphere, and right-hand side in northern hemisphere. That process is known as the Farrell's law. FERRELS, Farrell's law. Gushan said, does sun rays affect the direction of a wind? No. Yes, partially it affected, because at the time of a sun rays, if the duration of a day is a longer, surface will receive as a more heat. If the sun rays are fall as a vertical, surface will receive as a more heat. Under such circumstances, high temperature will lead to the development of a low atmospheric pressure. And those areas where as a slanting sun rays are fall means polar regions. When we move from away from the equator, under such circumstances, the sun rays, it may be fall as a slanting sun rays towards the polar regions. Under such circumstances, the high pressure will develop over the high latitudes. Like as a cool bird areas, north pole, south pole. Clear? Is that clear? So winds which are originate from a 30 degree south are known as a southeasterlies. These winds are known as a southeasterlies. Why? Because winds are originate from a southern hemisphere, south of the equator. They originate from Jabji Coriolis, is spelled as a C-O-R-C-O-R-I-O-L-I-S. Coriolis is a force exerted on Earth's surface due to its rotation. Earth rotates as an anti-clockwise. Clock rotates as this, but the Earth rotates as an anti-clockwise from west to east. Earth rotate as the anti-clockwise from west to east. Due to rotation of Earth, force which develop on the surface of the Earth, it leads to the diversion of winds is known as a Coriolis. Clear, Japji? It is known as the Coriolis force. Coriolis force diverted the winds left-hand side in a southern hemisphere, right-hand side in a northern hemisphere. That phenomena is known as the Farrell's law. Clear? Is that clear? So winds which are moving from a south of equator towards the equator world, subtropical high pressure areas towards the equatorial low pressure areas, due to the Coriolis force, these are diverted as a left hand side. These winds are known as a southeasterlies because they are originated from the southern hemisphere, moving from east towards westward. So same as the winds which are blowing in a northern hemisphere are known as the northeasterlies. Clear? Till there, any questions? These southeasterlies, they are becomes as a southwest monsoon winds when they cross the equator. Now pay attention, everybody. Southeasterlies, when they cross the equator, they turn the right-hand side. Then these winds are known as the southwesterlies. Why do they turn? Due to the Coriolis force. Earth has regularly rotates around its axis. around its axis. That's why the winds are diverted on the surface of the earth crust. Winds are diverted in a earth crust. Clear?
So these winds, which originate from a southern hemisphere known as a southeasterlies, cross the equator, cross the equatorial low pressure belt, and turns right hand side, which are known as a southwesterlies. Southwesterlies or southwest monsoon winds.
These one that aspect has related to the origin of Indian monsoons. Southwesterlies. These are known as the southwesterlies or southwest monsoon winds. It has given on your book on page number 3-4. Check it. Clear? Till there any questions? So keep this thing in your mind. Southwesterlies winds, which are crossed the equator, turns the right hand side, known as the southwesterlies. These are known as the southwesterlies. Southwesterlies. So some of the assumptions used by the Gilbert in relation to the Indian monsoons. Assumptions. He assumed that why do as the winds are moving from the south towards the northward in a month of June? So what were the reasons responsible for this? For this as a, he assumed a certain number of things. First assumption in relation to the Indian monsoons. First assumption. Growth of ITCZ. ITCZ is an intertropical convergence zone. ITCZ. ITCZ, it is what? This is as a narrow zone which has lights from 0 to 5 degree north and south. 0 to 5 degree north and 5 degree south. This is a dynamic in nature. As for the Earth's inclination, Earth is not as a vertical. This is tilted in a one side. Earth tilted in a one side as a 66 and a half degree. In that state, that hemisphere of the Earth which receives the more heat, it leads to the shifting of ITCZ, this equatorial low pressure belt towards the north, and during a time of October, November, December, when the southern hemisphere tilted in front of the sun, in that state, they may be as the ITCZ shifted towards the south. It is a dynamic in nature. Ye permanent nahi hai. Except equatorial low pressure belt, rest of the all six belts are the permanent. They are not shifted from their place. I am repeating as a ITCZ, intertropical convergence zone. Intertropical convergence zone. Clear? So let's continue. ITCZ, intertropical convergence zone, which is dynamic in nature. Earth ki inclination ke accordingly, it has changing their position from 0 to 5 degree north or 5 degree south. 5 degree north and 5 degree south. 5 degree north and 5 degree south, that ITCZ has shifted. Due to as a shift of the ITCZ, winds are moving in that particular hemisphere. For example, northeasterlies, which are developing from subtropical high pressure belt towards the equator, crossing the equator, they turns the right hand side, which are known as the southwesterlies. Sorry, northwesterlies. These are known as a northwesterlies. So, as their opposite, our chapter is in relation to the monsoons. When southeasterlies,
southeasterlies originate from the southern hemisphere, crossing the equator turns the right hand side, which are known as the southwest monsoon winds.
These are known as the southwest monsoon winds. Clear? Southwest monsoon winds. So first assumption in relation to the Indian monsoons as a ITCZ, which is a dynamic in nature, it changed their position as per the temperature changes in northern and southern hemisphere. First assumption. In between our northern and the southern hemisphere, it shifted. ITCZ shift from a equator to northward and equator to southward. As per the thermal changes, temperature changes, because Earth is tilted in a 66.5 degree. So this is as a first assumption. When ITCZ shifted towards the north, in that state, India has experienced, the northern plains of India experienced as the hot summers, hot and dry summers. And as we discussed, high temperature means as a low atmospheric pressure. Low pressure attracts the winds from a south towards northward, which are the sea breezes. Winds moving from the sea to the land are the sea breezes, which brings the rain and, which brings the moisture and causes the rain in India, which is known as a monsoons. First assumption. Now, the second one is the intense heat, which is receiving on a Tibetan plateau. Tibet is, this is known as the roof of the world. Tibet is known as the roof of the world. At the state of a summer solstice, when sun rays are fall vertical over a tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degree north. In that state, the Tibet plateau is intensely heated during the summers. Which results in strong vertical air currents and formation of the high pressure over the plateau. Formation of high pressure over plateau at about as the kilometers from the mean sea level. When we start to measure the height, we are using as a mean sea level. We measure the height from the mean sea level. So in that state, the Tibet has experienced a high temperature. So that's why as the winds are moving from the south towards northward. Gushan, very good. Kerala towards the Jammu and Kashmir. So third assumption, Tibetan plateau intensely heated during the summers. Fourth one, the movement of the westerlies. Movement of westerly jet winds to the north of the Himalayas and a presence of the tropical easterlies jet over the Indian Peninsula during the summers.
As we discussed, this is as the subtropical high pressure belt, subpolar, low pressure belt. So winds are moving from high pressure towards low pressure. Winds which are moving from high pressure to the low pressure equatorial low pressure or subpolar low pressure areas.
In that state, the westerly jet winds are blowing in the Himalayas and the presence of a tropical easterlies jet over the Indian Peninsula during the summers. It has also makes possibilities for movement of winds from the south towards the north, because when winds are moving from the subtropical high pressure belt areas towards the other areas, that deficiency of winds has accomplished by the winds moving from the south towards the northward. South towards the northward. Next assumption is as the intensity and the position of the high pressure areas affects the Indian monsoons. The intensity and position of the high pressure areas developing over Indian Ocean, high pressure areas developing over Indian Ocean, which affects the Indian monsoons. It affects the Indian monsoons. I'm again repeating the intensity and position of high pressure developing over Indian Ocean, it affects the Indian monsoons. Clear? It affects the Indian monsoons. Next assumption, the heat low around the Arabian Sea. The heat low around the Arabian Sea caused due to the intensive heating during the pre-monsoon months. Pre-monsoon months are the before of the monsoons when the summers are experiencing in a northern India. Summers are extend in April and May. Afterwards, the end of May, the monsoons, rainy season begin. Expected time of a monsoons in India is the first 10 days of June. First 10 days of June, monsoons are arriving on a coast of Kerala. If they arrive before of their time or afterwards their time, it adversely impact over a economy. How? Because our economy based upon agriculture. If the monsoons are arriving before of its time, because April and May is the time period of a harvesting of a wheat. If the rain recorded in a month of April and May, this is a disastrous. This is as degrading the quality of grains. If rain recorded in a month of April and May at the time of harvesting of wheat, or either if the rain has recorded in a month of July or afterwards the June, it also adversely impact over India, because it will delay the paddy season, kharif season, paddy crop. Paddy crop generally, rice has generally sowing in a month of June with the arrival of the monsoons. Because as you learned, India has facing as a scarcity of water. So water necessity for the agriculture has basically acquired from the rain. If rain has not recorded on their time, it adversely impact over the production. Farmer, they will sowing as a crops in delay. Delay in production means the next crop, it will be sowing in a or more delay. It will